Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. Today I am taking up a chapter in which Vidur gives advice to Dhritarashtra how to settle the family dispute and why to do so urgently. Vidur is one sensible person in the court of Dhritarashtra who is not afraid to give advice according to his own thinking, which is free thinking and open mind. He is also the prime minister of the state, although he is not liked by Duryodhana and company. He starts his narrative by telling Dhritarashtra that there is a tale which he had heard from his ancestors. A hunter spread a net over earth to catch some sparrows. Two sparrows got caught in the net. They used to fly together, eat together, talk together. They lifted the net and flew onwards in the sky. The hunter was not disappointed, rather he followed them in any direction in which the birds flew. He was running fast, he kept pace with them. He reached a forest where some munis were living. They were just free from their evening ablutions and sandhya. When they saw him, they asked him, "Why are you chasing them?" "They are flying in the sky, you are running on the earth. How would you catch them?" The hunter replied, "Both these words have come together. That is how they are carrying away my net. When they will quarrel with each other, they will come down, fall onto the ground, and I shall catch them." It so happened after some time that those two silly birds started quarreling with each other, and in that quarrel they fell down onto the ground, still trapped in the net. The hunter moved ahead, caught hold of both of them. Similarly, Rajan, the members of a family who fight with each other over wealth, power, property, they are trapped in the net like these birds. And once they are trapped like that, they would be caught by their enemies in a weaker position. It is customary, it is necessary, it is obligatory that people who are relatives to each other sit together, eat together, talk to each other affectionately, look after each other's health, happiness and sorrows. They are all the time making an effort to move together, to help each other. It is not for them to oppose each other, which is happening today in our family. Listeners, please remember that Vidur was a part of the family. He was also fathered by Vyas, who had fathered Dhritarashtra and Pandu. The only thing is he was born of a maid servant. And that hurt him all his life. He continued telling Dhritarashtra that those with pure hearts, those members of a family who listen to their elders are like lions in a forest, very well protected by themselves. No enemy dare approach them. On the other hand, Bharat Shrestha, those who even after they have cornered all the wealth of the family are all the time pining for more and more, quarrel with each other, help in the transfer of their property and assets to their enemies. Bharat Kul Bhushan Dhrit Rashtra, if logs of wood are kept together, they would not burn together, they would only emit smoke. But if they are put together, their fire, their flames will reach the skies. That is the advantage of unity. Unity is strength, Rajan. Please listen to me. I have seen these things happening. I shall give you another instance. I was accompanying a group of Bhil tribes and Brahmins going north to Gandhamadan mountain. The Brahmins wanted to collect knowledge as well as herbs, roots. They were very intelligent people. To our astonishment, we found that in a cave which was difficult to approach, which had almost no opening, there was a beehive, but it had not been made there by the bees. It was golden in color and looked like a pot. It was protected by serpents, poisonous reptiles. Kuber loved this particular honey. My companions, the Brahmins, said that this particular honey can make a human immortal. It can restore the sight to a blind man. It can restore youth to an old man. Hearing these qualities of the pot of honey, the Bhils tried to reach it, but the serpents bit them and killed all of them. Vidur continued, Tathaiva tav putro ayam prithvim eka icchati madu pashyati sammohat prapatam na anupashyati. Thus, your son Duryodhan wants to enjoy this earth alone as its absolute ruler. In his greed, he only sees the honey pot. He cannot think beyond it. He cannot think of the consequences of obtaining this honey pot. Duryodhan is thinking of fighting a war with Arjun. But Maharaj, I do not see in him neither the glory nor the valor of Arjun. Arjun alone, riding his chariot, has conquered the world. When Bhishma, Drona, great warriors, went to fight at Viratnagar, Arjun made them run from the battlefield. Such is his valor and strength. You know of it, Rajan. Even today, that warrior is waiting for a gesture of friendship from you, from your son, from the Kaurava brothers, and from this court. If you would be kind to them, to the Pandavas, they would forget and forgive you all that has been done in the past. And Pandavas are not alone. The kings Drupad, Virat are with them. The Pandava brothers are very powerful, Maharaj. Drupad, Virat and Arjun, riding on the winds, helped by the god of winds, Pavan, will ignite a fire when they attack your forces. No one would survive on your side. O Maharaja, brother Dhritarashtra, please invite Yudhishthira to come and sit in your lap. He is your nephew. He is a good person. He is Dharmaraj, who follows a principled life in everything that he does. However, if you do not do this, and once the battle lines are drawn, I cannot predict who would win and who would lose. Dhritarashtra listened to this carefully. He called his son Duryodhana, told him, "You are on the wrong path, but you think you are following the right path. It is your misunderstanding under which you are trying to fight the Pandav brothers and deprive them of everything that they can have legitimately. In this fight, my son, you would be the loser, not the Pandavas. You would lose your life. It is just not possible that you would win over them." Yudhishthira is Dharmaraj. He sticks to dharma, his duty, his principles under all circumstances. You cannot defeat him. There is none who can fight Bhim in valor on the face of this earth. Your challenging him is like a tree challenging a gale, a wind that would uproot you. Bhim, the son of Kunti, is Yamraj for you. He is not going to spare your life. and you are daring to challenge him to your utter detriment. Arjun is the best archer in the world. He is like Meru amongst the mountains. Which wise man will challenge him on the battlefield? Drishtadyumna, the son of the Panchal king, can rain arrows on your forces like the clouds shower rain on the earth. You would not be able to pierce the curtains of arrows thrown by Drishtadyumna. Satyaki is a warrior incomparable in valor. He is all the time with Pandavas. If a war starts, he would destroy your forces. And then do not forget about Bhagavan Krishna. He is higher than all the three worlds. He is with them. He is with the Pandavas. How would you fight them? He treats Arjun affectionately and treats him equal to even his family, his relatives. He can give up all this for the sake of Arjun, and you want to fight him? You are an idiot, Duryodhan. Wherever there is Arjun, the son of Pandu, who has controlled his senses, there you would find Krishna, the son of Vasudeva. And any army in which Krishna is present is invincible. Duryodhan, listen to me. Listen to your grandfather, Bhishma. I think only of the welfare of the Kauravas. Acharya, Dron, Krip, Vikarn, Maharaj Valik, they are all your well-wishers. You should respect them as you respect me. Listen to all of them. Make friends with the cousins, the Pandavas. We stop here. We shall take up another very fascinating tale in the next video. Thank you for listening to me.